Lots of ships use the harbor at the big station by the sea. The passenger ships have spotless paint and green glass. Other ships are smaller and dirtier, but important too. They take coal, machinery, and other things abroad and bring back meat, timber, and things we need. Fishing boats also come there. They unload their fish on the quay. Some of it is sent to shops in the town, and some goes in a special train to other places far away. The railwaymen call this train the Flying Kipper. One winter evening, Henry's driver said, "We'll be out early tomorrow. We've got to take the Flying Kipper." "Don't tell Gordon," he whispered, "but I think if we pull the kipper nicely, the fat controller will let us pull the express." "Hurrah!" cried Henry, excited. "That will be lovely." He was ready at 5 o'clock. There was snow and frost. Men hustled and shouted, loading the vans with crates of fish. The last door banged, the guard showed his green lamp, and they were off. Come on, don't be silly, don't be silly," puffed Henry to the vans as wheels slipped on the icy rail. The vans shuddered and groaned, "Trunk, trunk, 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 all right," they answered grudgingly. That's better," puffed Henry more happily as the train began to gather speed. Thick clouds of smoke and steam poured from his funnel into the cold air, and when his fireman put on more coal, the fire's light shone brightly on the snow around. "Hurry, hurry, hurry," panted Henry. They whooshed under bridges and clattered through stations, green signal lights showing as they passed. They were going well, the light grew better, and a yellow signal appeared ahead. "Distance signal up," thought Henry, "caution." His driver, shutting off steam, prepared to stop, but the home signal was down. "All clear, Henry, away we go." They couldn't know, the points from the main line to a siding were frozen. But that signal had been set in danger. A fall of snow had forced it down. A goods train waited in the siding to let the Flying Kipper pass. The driver and fireman were drinking cocoa in the brake van. The guard pulled out his watch. "The kipper's due," he said. "Who cares?" said the fireman. "This is good cocoa." The driver got up. "Come on, fireman, back to our engine." "Hey," the fireman grumbled, "I haven't finished my cocoa yet." The three men shot in the air like jacks in the box and landed in the snow outside. Henry's driver and fireman jumped clear before the crash. The fireman fell headfirst into a heap of snow. He kicked so hard that the driver couldn't pull him out. Henry sprawled on his side. He looked surprised. The goods train fireman waved his empty mug. "You clumsy great engine. The best cup of cocoa I've ever had, and you bump into me and spill it all." "Never mind your cocoa, fireman," laughed his driver. "Run and telephone the breakdown gang." The gang soon cleared the line, but they had hard work lifting Henry to the rails. The fat controller came to see him. "The signal was down, sir," said Henry nervously. "Cheer up, Henry. It wasn't your fault. Ice and snow caused the accident. I'm sending you to Crewe, a fine place for sick engines. They'll give you a new shape and a larger firebox. Then you will feel a different engine and won't need special coal anymore. Won't that be nice?" "Yes, sir," said Henry doubtfully. Henry liked being at Crewe, but he was glad to return. A crowd of people waited to see him arrive in his new shape. He looked so splendid and strong that they gave him 3 cheers. "Peep, peep, pip, pip, peep. Thank you very much," he whistled happily. "I'm sorry to say, a lot of little boys are often late for school because they wait to see Henry in the back. They often see him pulling the express, and he does it so well that the board is jealous."